You know, then I also talk about the question of Uganda's troubled history in terms of the presidential election challenges. You know, I also, some of the things I capture them under the call, will be solidinam facit pasem appellate, which means that they make dissolution and call it peace. Then I also talk about issues to do with electoral democracy, aspects to do with the infringement of right to privacy, aspects to do with the infringement of the right to the internet, for example. I mean, how many times have the internet been closed down? You probably even up to now, Facebook is maybe not even accessible. So the argument of those in terms of the law, what is the law? What does the law say? How are we supposed to talk about that? How about the Computer Misuse Act? You know, those aspects. How about the introduction of the 12% exercise duty on data? You know, so those are aspects that I want to talk about also in this particular component. So I urge you that this is a must read for anyone who wants to have a peace with constitutional law in as far as constitutional jurisprudence is concerned in this country. So this is a must read. Then I go to another new novel area, which I call the law of forensics, which we call a proof beyond the shadow of doubt. Now under this, I make a lot of arguments because this is a must read. We have had so many challenges in terms of unanswered questions of motorbike, you know, mafia, like kind of standoffs, you know, where there are many unfortunate people have actually died. So I make arguments in this book in terms of trying to demystify or answer some of those questions. I talk about the origin of forensic, okay? I talk about the principles of forensic in terms of practice. I talk about forensic science and the law. I talk about aspects to do with burden of proof. I talk about issues to do with the different types of criminology, if you like. How about, you know, how do you procure evidence in forensics? How about the chain of evidence? How about how do you record? Aspects to do with the different types of evidence. Aspects to do also with the criminal proceeding in terms of forensics. You know, aspects to do with when it comes to, for example, the different pleas. Okay, then I also talk about criminal profiling. You know, aspects to do with logic, reasoning, and methods of criminal profiling. I talk about aspects to do with the forensic pathology, you know, which is also important, and the times of the different types of forensic pathology in terms of the state, in terms of medicine, you know, and medical jurisprudence, if you like, aspects to do with the self-induced or automatism. Those are aspects that, and then things to do with DNA, fingerprint in terms of forensics, advancement of DNA technology, you know, the different types of analysis, DNA technology analysis. You talk about the PCR analysis, the STR analysis, the mitochondrial DNA analysis, the chromosome analysis. So all these aspects, I discuss them in terms of DNA, if you like. And then what we call also forensic victimology. What do we mean by that? Distinguish between forensic victimology. Also, I talk about writing forensic reports. I talk about aspects to do with the forensic opinions and expert testimonies, criminal investigations of sorts. So this book is a must read for every person who's interested in trying to solve these so-called cold matters that this country has actually been engaging in, whether it's poison, whether it's bullet shots, or whether it's unanswered deaths. This is a must read because it's going to be helpful to, it's a tool map, or it's a tool for every serious person who wants to have answers in terms of investigative or criminology of sorts. So this is important. So it's about 19 chapters, so I cannot go have enough time to go into the liberties of everything, but you can readily find it, as I said, on our website as well. Then we have another one that is just coming in. It's called Demystifying the Order from Baba. Why that the people versus the Attorney General when the forces exceed their constitutional mandate? The ideology here is that how many times we see forces, whether they take the semblance of police or military or call them LDUs, how many times do you see them, you know, encroaching and infringing on the rights of the ordinary people? Do we have, a procedure in terms of how they're supposed to do their things? So these are questions that I'm asking. How about, again, my argument in terms of the Postal Commutators Act, whether or not it's applicable in Uganda, you know, I borrow heavily from the American jurisprudence because many times we see army people in terms of being employed to enforce civilian duties. The question is, isn't that an infringement on our constitutional rights? So those answers are found here. And how about when a civilian or an individual is actually, you know, their rights have been overridden? Do they have a remedy? And that remedy is what I talk about, the people versus the Attorney General. The Attorney General being a representative of government, and therefore the right constitutional body to sue when it comes to infringement of personal rights, if you like. That is another important book. Now, this other one here, It's called The Law of Penology. And the argument behind this book is that it's a legal philosophical appraisal of the need to amend the law. Why we talk about penology? Because, and it's called I Can't Breathe. Some of you probably know where that phrase comes from. The argument here is that we have instances, for example, when the law, in spite of its doing a good job, is actually becomes an ass, to use Charles Dickens' words. The argument here is that there are certain aspects of the law that need to be amended, whether in terms of marriage, for example, what we call, for example, in the law of rape, you know, where we're saying the power differential can equal, you know, rape or can equal coercion of sorts. Those arguments I present in these books, there are many, many other things, but I don't want to preempt. I want to encourage you so that you can have the importance of actually going back and finding these books. As I say, all these materials are readily available on lubogo.org, and you can also find them at twogenerationslawapps.com. But also, many of these books are readily available in many of the major bookstores in this country, both on digital draft and also Smashwords, and also Apple, and also Aristo, and also Uganda Bookshop, and also in almost all major libraries in this country. Go to Makerere, you'll find them. Go to Uganda Christian University, you'll find them. Go to Komba University, you'll find them. Go to Islamic University in Uganda, you're gonna find them. So these are important. Go to KIU, you're gonna find them. So this is important jurisprudence in the making. And I've summarized almost all these works in this book that we call The Complete Works of Isaac Christopher Lobo, which is abridged. We're talking about where I call myself an animus optimum legalis, who thrives under animus opibisci parati in a sui generis generation. So this book has almost those components, as I said. We talks about the sui generis law app, the treatise to my learned friend, the history of Busoga, Ubuntu Ulamo and the Law, executive constitutional mandate, intelligent design, freedom through law, stuff like that. And then, of course, these other new books that are coming. So this book summarizes some of the things that we've been doing. So my friends, again, I plead to you that this is a moment that you need to welcome, so that you can become one of those people who will appreciate the components of the law in its reality. So this is the law. This is the law in the making. We're going to change the jurisprudence of this country. We're going to be able to improve in terms of legal discourse for purposes of appreciating the law and bringing the law to your fingertips. So, my friends, God bless you, and thank you for giving me the attention to explain to you some of the works that the hand of God has been gracious to do. To God be the glory. To God Almighty be the glory. This is not a work of man, but this is an inspiration by the grace of God. So God bless you, and thank you for your attention.